To save me from myself, I was made to wear gloves on my hands as a child. And every time my godmother scolded me for playing with my scabs, resentment seared in my chest like wine on an iron skillet, itching all too much like the plague God rained on Egyptian families. My room sang like I was trying to start a fire with stones. My first line of defense left discolored, stubborn, all too ready to bring attention to my leprosy. My parents' faces wrinkled like prunes, and I, like an alcoholic at an intervention, was put on trial for a disease I didn't ask for. I learned at the age of 8 that pain could hurt so good, and sometimes your limbs are not your friends. My godmother's frustration was more obnoxious than the volume of Saturday morning cartoons, but she was teaching me something about scabs, about scars, about wounds. Picking at them only limited their stay, only gave them more ground to lodge themselves in a grave. I called my skin, and maybe sometimes God can't do what he wants with us because we are too busy reopening our scabs. It might get infected, sounded too much like boy. You might lose a limb, but what do you do when a child's pain becomes his comfort zone? All too overt that we tamper with our scabs too much, too long, lost too many limbs, too much blood, trying to hold on to too much pain. I cannot speak for you. But I am still learning how to refrain from picking at my scabs. I'm still learning to allow my pain to make peace with the rest of my skin, to regrow the pieces of myself that I lost with my infected limbs.